This is Todd Ogasawara, MobileViews.com, and I'm taking a look at Looptastic Producer. Now, there are a couple of editions of Looptastic for the iPhone and iPod Touch, and this is an iPod Touch, by the way. The difference between Looptastic Producer and the other editions, I believe, is its ability to import loops. And it does this by creating a web server on your iPod Touch or iPhone itself. Basically uses port 8080, which is a common port to use for alternative web browsers. And you would be able to, copy files from your PC or Mac over to your iPod Touch or iPhone using this built-in web browser. But what I'm going to do is show you how the rest of it works. And I guess this part is similar to the other editions, and I don't claim to be an expert at it. One thing to notice is that it takes a little while to load, and I don't think this is something that should bother you, because basically it's doing a lot. As you can see, there's a bunch of different loops. It's color-coded for different things. These are percussion. If you touch it, you can see a little pop-up, pop-out telling you that the greens are the bass. The blues tend to be lead instruments and rhythm. And this red one happens to be a vocal. So let's push that up here. And moving this up and down changes the volume level for that particular thing. So now we can bring up, say, a bass. That's the bass right there. And we'll bring in the kick and snare. And let's see, what's this guy over here? That's some kind of percussion. Here, let's see. You can really hear that. Now you'll notice that we have three segments here, and basically there's a little slider here. So you notice the vocals on the right, and that's all we're hearing. We slide there. We push it here, we hear the percussion, and things in the middle are always heard regardless of where we go left or right. Now there are a couple of tabs here. This one lets you modify the sound. I'm not really sure how this works. I know there are a couple waveforms here. Wave going down, up, kind of a sine and a cosine kind of thing. I think I'm going to send some email to the creator of this, who I've been in contact with, and ask them to do a podcast with me to explain exactly how this thing is supposed to work. Let's put that back. There we go. And that's it. And that brings you back to the list of presets you have in. And again, really the key to this is to import your own loops. Okay, that's it. This is Looptastic. Todd Ogasawara, MobileViews.com. Talk to you next time. Now let's get back there.